You have to have some influence somewhere. You are just a, I believe that, you are just a sort of a jigsaw puzzle or a collage of all what is around you. You pick everything up from the society, from the circumstances and from around you. Without the circumstances, you cannot be creative.
Hello and welcome. You're watching Lockdown Art Series with me, Nagesh Rao Sardesai. I'm doing an interview with one of my very close friends, a person whom I love to interact because I get to know a lot of things from him, new things from him from different perspective. He's Shirish Desai. He's a good friend of mine. He studied in the same school that I studied in and went on to graduate from the same college, Goa College of Art, in fine arts, in painting, and then moved to Mumbai to pursue his passion, that is photography and cinematography. That he was in fact bitten by this bug at a very young age, and his father realized his potential. So moving to Mumbai after his graduation, he involved himself passionately into photography and cinematography. Luckily, he worked with some of the best in the industry. I would say he worked not just with the best of the industry, but he worked with the icons of the industry, and he learned a lot from them. And now he's doing on his own different films. He's also teaching in an institute in Pune, and he scuttles between Pune and Mumbai. I would also like to say that his house, this is very important, because I would like to say that his house was basically a place where people took refuge in. His house was like, nobody was asked a question. Everyone who came there was given lunch and dinner and even place to stay. Sometimes they were even not known to them personally. So his house is that blessed. These are the people who are socially conscious. His father was a politician, but he was a politician of a different kind. He was a socially conscious politician who instilled this art, or rather I would say instilled this emotions in them of serving the people, of looking after them, at least trying to minimize their pains. And this is how Shirish Desai was born in that family and grew up. I am also fortunate to say that I took my lessons in tabla in his house from my second tabla guruji, that is Bugde Guruji. And I in fact also would like to say that his sister, Shirish's sister, used to learn, take lessons in sitar, and she played wonderful sitar. I don't know whether she continues. We'll come to know about it in due course of time. I would like to welcome, a very warm welcome to Shirish Desai. Shirish Bab, welcome to the show.
Thank you for the wonderful introduction, Nagesh. Tell me.
Okay, Shirish Bab, let us get to the point. This interview started with the series started with lockdown, and obviously it happened because of the pandemic, COVID-19 and so on. So things changed, the social dynamics changed, the how we interact changed, everything changed. Everything, the world has gone topsy-turvy from my point of view. Or rather, it has gone back to the old days when we unnecessarily did not spend much, unnecessarily did not eat out and so on and so forth. That's a point of view everybody can have. I would like to know from you, what are your views about the whole thing happening now? The pandemic, the situation outside, the social issues, the economic issues. What do you think about it as a human being?
See, it all, I look at it as a thing that has happened and which was supposed to happen, because everything was going to a saturation point. Everything. I mean, all our connections, all our conversations, all our meetings, eating out, as you said, everything. It had reached a saturation point where it has to restart from somewhere. So I look at it not as a human thing, but it's a nature's call. And I suppose we have to adhere to it, because there is no other way otherwise. Okay. So it happened, but then looking at it as a disadvantage is something which I will never do. Because I don't think it is a disadvantage. I think, like today, you and me are talking on this phone and we are conversing with the world. It is only because of the pandemic, otherwise it would have not happened.
That's true.
That is a fact. That's true. I wouldn't have been able to express my views over here or even in the other forums where they call me, they talk to me about it. If not for this pandemic, this much of ideas would not have been exchanged. They were there with us, they were dormant with us, everything was there. But at the same time, we were not letting them out anywhere, or even only in private conversations, or in the college, or while we were shooting. Okay, it is only then when you bestow knowledge with each other. But today, it is like a plethora, which is open to everybody. It's a plethora of knowledge, it is open to everybody today. Today, you and I are talking over here. Something we know each other for donkey's years, but did we ever talk?
That's true.
No. Whenever we met in Goa, yeah, a little exchange happened, or on the telephonic conversation sometimes. But otherwise, no. Otherwise, who knew what is happening?
We didn't talk later.
Everybody had their private lives. Today, there are no private lives. Today, we are exchanging with people. We are trying to, because that is the need. What are you going to say quarantined in the house? You have to communicate.
That is true.
Okay. And communication is much better now than it was before pandemic. So I look at it as a wonderful advantage to exchange ideas, to be with people, you know, and also educate yourself. I think I saw so many films which I had not seen for all these years.
That's
simply because I had to sit at home and I had to work on my thing. I wrote so many scripts. But otherwise, I was not getting time. I was either shooting or jumping around or going to on traveling. So there was hardly any time for you to sit in one place and do something constructive. Today, I see so many people holding dance classes, so many people holding crafts classes, so many people doing. But this isn't this an advantage? And they are earning money on, by the way. So many people who are also financially getting a new platform to execute. And mm-hmm. I don't look at it as a disadvantage at all. We need, see, what was happening earlier was an expel of energies in useless roads. That is not happening now. So I wouldn't look at it as a disadvantage at all. It is an advantage. And it also, whatever hurdles come in front of you, okay, even if it is a hurdle, how to turn it into an advantage is up to you. Or whether you're going to sit and cry about it, or whether you're going to do something about it. If you do something about it, there is a whole lot of world open for you. If you want to whine and cry, then yeah, you can live in your shell. I don't see any problem in that also. People have choices. Yeah.
So. And it's very nice that you have put it in a very positive way. Not looking at the disadvantage of it, but looking at the advantage of it, which is very difficult, because many people today, even if having so many things, will continuously whine about it, as you said. But you have looked at the positive side and how we can actually grow. In fact, the very fact that there are many classes that have come up, I know many people who have done this. In fact, they have shot videos and put them on the YouTube, which they wouldn't have done that, because they would be busy doing something else, as you said. And now they have seen a different avenue.
Yeah, but you see, all the while net was used for bickering.
That's true.
Fighting with each other.
That's true.
Putting up your strong views,
yeah,
which don't mean anything to each other, you know, and basically making a mess out of it.
That's
true. Today, people want to come together because we have realized the futility of life.
Mm.
There is really no time to waste. I was just having a conversation with a person in the morning. He said, I'm 60 and I'm tired. So I tell him, you're 60, you're 60, you're old. Yes, it's fine, but you are not old in your mind. Kartutvak age nasta. Body has an age. Kartutvak age nasta. It is ageless. You can decide to do anything at any amount of time. And you can do it if you want. But only thing is that you should want to do something out of it. So social media is a wonderful tool. If you use it properly, if you misuse it, then of course it is going to have its own faults. I think this pandemic has taught many people many beautiful lessons. And I look at it in that way, because it has taught me so many. Seriously, I got my four scripts complete. And that's a big advantage. Otherwise, I would have been sitting around. So, yes.
Yeah, that's true. And as you said, there's no limit. You cannot limit things by your age. Age is limitless, and your mind has to be limitless more than the age.
Age is a number.
Yeah, age is a number. That's it. You can remember Abdul Kalam the president of India, the past president of India, former president of India, was giving a lecture when he collapsed and died. Something really great. He did that till the end of his life. That is very important.
Yeah. One of my colleague too, Rajat Kotari, who is a cinematographer of Perfume, he also collapsed while he was holding classes.
Oh.
Yeah, he was holding classes and he is a very close friend of mine. And he was holding classes in the Whistling Woods. And while he was holding classes, he just collapsed and died. Nothing wrong with him.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
But I don't say everybody has to go through that.
That's
okay.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you should be working till you can.
At least mentally, mentally you should continue.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah. You should continue. Because there's something or the other you can always do. If your hands and legs are not working, at least your fingers are.
Yeah.
Sit and type.
Yeah, that's exactly.
You can do something.
At least guide somebody. If you cannot do anything.
Yeah, guide somebody. Tell something to somebody. There are so many fields in which you can work with them. So I don't see any problem.
Right.
Anyway, unless you have it in your own mind,
right?
Then you have to solve it. Yeah.
Okay. Let me ask you a very important question. In fact, how did you get into art, fine art, photography, cinematography, whatever? How did you get into it? I don't think there was a background in that sense where you could get inspired.
No. See, nothing starts without a beginning somewhere. Prior to where you were born, you know. Nothing starts just from you. Okay. You have to have some influence somewhere. You are just a, I believe that, you are just a sort of a jigsaw puzzle or a collage of all what is around you. You pick everything up from the society, from the circumstances and from around you. Without the circumstances, you cannot be creative.
Right.
Or creativity cannot explode. You have to have the seed in you. But it has to basically be watered by and manured by things around you. You cannot be all by yourself. Okay, suddenly I am Chitrakala discover kili. Okay. Although we would like to believe that.
Mm.
But no, it is not that way. There is a beginning somewhere. I think it was my uncle who used to paint. Sometimes, you know, and he used to paint the same picture for donkey's ears, but still he used to like it.
Okay.
And he used to make him paint that.
Okay.
I used to like to see how, now there is my brother, there are my sisters, everybody was there. Now everybody was seeing him painting. Okay. But I liked it. Others didn't pick it up. Now that is the difference.
Mm.
Okay. Everybody doesn't become similar. Like, I'm going to call it Karere. बसीच्या पहिली कारवीचे वयर असे ते हे असताले असे कारवीचे वयर लाकडाची फळी असताली आणि त्या फळेचे तो देव हनुमान निर्माण पेंट करताले पहिले ओके तर ते पेंटिंग तो पेंटर येतालो कोणतरी सम पेंटर इज टू कम चंद्रकांत इज नेम वगैरे ही इज टू कम अँड ही इज टू पेंट दोज लेटर्स अँड ही इज टू पेंट त्याचे बारीक डिझाईन करत नाही मारुती राम असे पेंट करून ते वयर मागे लावत सो आय टू कॅन बी ऑब्झर्व हिम डुईंग दॅट
ओके
ओके सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स आय यूज टू इन्व्हाइट सो समवेअर देअर इट स्टार्टेड ओके समवेअर देअर इट स्टार्टेड देन माय डॅड इज टू गेट दिस मॅगझिन कॉल्ड धनंजय
धनंजय
धनंजय काय करतो तरी त्यातून ते मनोहर मुरगावकरांची पेंटिंग असतात मुरगावकर ओके मुरगावकर युज टू डू कृष्णा अँड गणपती आणि असे धार्मिक पेंटिंग असतात मोस्टली टू डू विथ राम आणि सोरी फ्रॉम महाभारत अँड रामायण
राईट
ओके ब्युटिफुली पेंटेड मुरगावकर ओके व्हेरी फेमस नाही सो आय युज टू सी दोज पेंटिंग्स स्लोली Also, we used to get a magazine called Span at home, American magazine. So those used to carry one art article always, where I was exposed to Miro, where I was exposed to Calder, where I was exposed to Picasso, Mondrian, Van Gogh. So I used to see these paintings. So somewhere there, I think it was getting built up. somewhere there it was getting built up. And of course, my uncle who was painting in front of me, or that guy who used to come and paint in front of us, that made a lot of difference. You know, choose the field, physically. That is how I started painting myself before I came to art college. And I suppose I used to do quite well. After printing, and not immediately. So, but I suppose I used to do well. And I remember Mr. Shantaram Amonkar. He was the person, Pratap Amonkar's father. He was the person who actually caught my hand one day and took me to the art college, which was bang opposite my house, opposite radio station.
Yeah.
Yeah. It, the first art college was there. And Mr. Patil was the principal of the college. And the first year, the students were Jiru Harmalkar and all this. So he took me there and he showed me the art college. And it is he who pokes my father ki aka art college in Gal. He is a good painter.
Uh-huh.
Okay, don't waste him. My father wanted me to go to medical.
Uh-huh.
Okay. But I was hell bent.
That was a trend then.
Dutur.
Yeah, Dutur.
Uh-huh.
So not an engineer.
So I said, no, I want to do this. After SSC, I straight away joined the art college. And also a great help from Amonkar sir.
Mm-hmm.
Great help. Okay. So my father came, he met Principal Pai. By the time Principal Pai was a principal, Lakshman Pai. Met Principal Pai. Shantaram Baba also came, he introduced me. And I was through. I think it was 1978. So I joined art college, and from there the journey starts. Okay. From there the journey. Photography was something which was there in my house. My dad used to click pictures.
Sorry, you did painting actually. You did fine arts.
I did fine arts.
That was not in commercial art basically. The photography part of it. I'm just saying.
Yeah. Photography was taught in the commercial, but I was doing photography on my own. I did not go to the commercial section to learn photography.
Okay.
I used to do it on my own. I had my own cameras and I used to do stuff on my own physically. So, but it was limited to clicking picnic pictures, basically going for somehow then Devan Galangal thing. Just travel pictures, nothing more. But I understood. And because my dad taught me a lot of technique, developing and printing tech,
uh-huh.
He used to himself click pictures. He had a Rolleiflex in those two lenses, twin lens camera. And he used to also take a lot of pictures of his friends, of us at home, functions, and all that. So he used to always be there around with his camera. So he is the guy who taught me how to see through the camera, how to click the pictures, exposure kasa dorbazo, speed kasa set karbaji, stand kenna use karbazo, tripod kenna na use karbazo, how to hold the camera steady. And he gifted me a Gava box camera when I was in fourth standard.
Oh.
It was a camera called Gava box.
Okay.
So it was a Gava camera. It was 120, bigger format, B2 size. Only 120, but a bigger size.
Okay.
So that camera my father gifted me first. After that, one of my mauso, who came from Bombay, also gifted me with a camera called Agfa Click 3. And then I started saving for cameras, buying cameras. But I was actually successfully clicking pictures when I was in 600 and from 400 onwards.
That's great.
Yeah, there was another person also called Dinesh Mangeshkar, who was Lata Mangeshkar's cousin. He was a close friend of ours, family friend actually. So whenever he used to come to Goa, he used to come and stay at our place.
Okay.
So he got a 35mm camera and he also taught me how to take pictures. Okay. Then I must have been in third or fourth. No, I must have been in first standard actually. Because I remember taking those pictures to second standard and showing to the students when I went to the convent. So he actually taught me how to hold the camera, take the pictures. I'm the cleaner acha picture, mechanic acha picture. Uh-huh. So that was my only subject. Was somebody washing the bath and all this sort of thing. So this picture I used to take, and it was a color film. I remember.
And you were encouraged to do that.
Yeah, my dad also encouraged me, and Dinesh Bhai also was always like, "Anna, tu kar, tu kar."
Why I'm saying is that because now, to a certain extent, it's fine because you can just click and you can just load it up. But at that point of time, I believe there were rules. You know, that also,
there were rules.
Yeah. So even otherwise, you
should
twice before clicking.
Because there were color rules, they had to go to Bombay and get developed, printed and come.
Ah, it was not available.
So there was no color developing in 1966-67. There was no color developing in
Goa.
Goa. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we used to do black and white.
Okay.
But but then also Bothell was there. Gregory Bothell.
Bothell.
Yeah, the judge. Who had this quality photographers down. Zubeda Bakery Marshall.
Yeah, barobar to hai. Singhbar Bookstall.
Singhbar Bookstall chakkar hai.
Yeah.
After that Franklin thing, which is there.
Yeah, yeah.
In between that, it was sandwiched a little. So he was the guy who also helped me a lot. Gregory Bothell.
Mm-hmm.
Used to take me there. They retouching karun shoot hai.
He was my neighbor, Patlan, Mayan, from Mala.
Mayan. Mm-hmm. So, Greg was also responsible for taking me there. But then there were various influences. That there was a friend of mine, he is a friend of mine, now he is abroad, called Shashank Naik, mm-hmm. Shashank Kamat. Uh-huh. Shashank Kamat's drawing poem was inspiration. Okay. I can also draw like it. Shashank now doesn't remember that he ever first drawing.
Inspired.
He's forgotten. So he said, Kenna re. I said, no, I used to draw both standards. And I used to look at your drawing and then I inspired.
Wow. That was school time.
So there are, yes, school time. Fourth standard. People's high school.
Yeah.
So thing is that, you know, you never know where you pick up things from. You pick up things and then you say that, no, but it is because of the circumstances, it's because of the people around you, people who encourage you at the right time, also helps a lot.
Yes.
If I was not encouraged, I would be doing something else.
Right.
You never know.
Right.
But I think people are destined to do what they want to do. It's okay. Yeah.
How did the filmmaking bug get into you? This is still photography. I mean, of course, you can graduate to that. But filmmaking was something that was completely... I would say a distant dream as far as Goans are concerned, at least. Because you had to go to Bombay, and at that point of time, it was like going to some other place and all that sort of
thing.
So how did you
go? Bombay is something I have to keep on coming.
I want to be a filmmaker. It's just like Bombay, what's up? Then you have to do all that thing. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So how did you think about it?
I didn't think about it. I was in art college, basically. It happened while I was in art college. This slow transition from photography, painting, music a bit. I learned tabla also. So all these things were happening in theater with Digambar Singhbar, Suhas Shilkar, and the theater. Okay. I did go on the stage also. So I sagar data na pata common par. We were all a group of friends who used to even I used to write plays with Baiju Parthan.
Oh.
I used to write plays also.
Okay.
So we used to do that also. Annual social like a play baro. So performing this plays in English. So these things are happening. Charu was there. Charudat
Prabhudasai.
So he was also writing and directing plays in school, in college. So all this sort of atmosphere, you know, very fulfilling atmosphere was there where you could easily transition was naturally for me to cinema, basically. There's a person called Suktankar, who started something called Vision Film Society in Goa, in Panjim. Okay. Suktankar was there, then there was a person called Raju Kulkarni. Okay. So, Rajiv Kulkarni, Apurva Kulkarni's brother.
Wow, yeah.
So, he and I don't remember very few people. They started something called Vision Film Society, where they used to get films and then they used to have Nishpak Festival and Satyajit Ray Festival, Ritvik Ghatak Festival. So, I started while going for that for the screenings, and that is when I discovered there is something better than something for me to express, not better than something for me to express over here. And along the time, I bought a Super 8 mm camera. This is a film camera, celluloid. Got films, started shooting. This is when my father encouraged me a lot. Okay, you get a 16 mm camera. Okay. And so on and so forth. But much before that, when I was somewhere in 6th, 7th standard, we accidentally went to see a film called Kagaz Ke Phool. We actually had gone to see a film called Himalaya Se Usha, some similar film. And that show was cancelled. And there was a Kagaz Ke Phool was there. And for the first time, I stood up to the fascinating imagery of black and white, which I had never seen before. Or I had seen, but I had not noticed. What is this? This strobe of light coming from top somewhere. How did he get this? You know, because it was like, why can I not do this? That sort of a question. Can I do this or not? So I have to meet this guy. Whoever has done this, I have to go and at least talk to him. Okay. So, but then it remained, and then I told, express this to my father. I want to see who the photographer of this film is. At that time, we knew photographers, no cinematographer. So who the photographer of this film is? So he said, "Arey, to show gaya lo. Aata na to ekul achil lo."
Yeah. Stop gap.
But he did take efforts. He did take efforts to, you know, he called up the archives, film archives. They janti film aldi thane. And in our hall, he showed me that.
Uh-huh.
Let us see who that, because he was also interested in knowing, perhaps.
Mm-hmm.
So he saw, okay, this is somebody called D.K. Murthy. Okay. So, okay, yeah, I would want to do this. So he said, yeah, pehle school so pahe, main poya. Okay. So, pehle pass da karo.
Typical.
But he said, you can always sit and imagine. No problem. And there were several other incidents, Nagesh, one day I remember how this poetry or imagery was installed into me. So one day I had expressed this on the Facebook also. Once I was walking with him in Altino, it had just rained. And rain the bandal. Then we went for the evening walk, me and my sister with my dad. Only two of us. Ata dhurum jen ata landa. So they were at the Miyasa Weather Observatory in Altino. At the Jesuit house.
Yeah.
So we were on that road of the Jesuit house. And suddenly he said, wait.
CM's
can
bungalow.
You see those three three coniferous trees? The coniferous trees, the Ashoka trees.
Mm.
Coniferous trees. They were swaying with the wind.
Uh-huh.
The atmosphere was absolutely beautiful in the evening. It was cool. I still remember. I can still feel it. And those trees were swaying. He said, look at those trees, how they're swaying. I said, yeah. Then he said, can you hear music? And I could hear music. Somebody was playing a record, long play record. So I heard, I said, yeah, there is music also. He said, see how those trees are swinging to the music.
Beautiful.
And I actually felt that the trees are swinging to the music. And trust me, till today, whenever I see, even if I'm in Kashmir, and I see that coniferous trees swinging, I can still listen to that music.
It's ingrained in your mind.
Actually, I can listen to that music. I mean, you can feel. Music is not playing anywhere. It plays in your mind.
Exactly.
But you can actually feel that. So that is how I think these small things are installed. As a road to go towards what I am today. I am.
It was getting paved for you.
It was getting paved subconsciously, consciously, unconsciously. I don't know. That is no more. But thing is that this small things which he did, small things he told me many a times, you know, were sort of windows to life. You know, were windows to life. Then that is how it happened. And then I started doing films. Then Mr. Pai also encouraged us. He used to look forward to our films. My films especially, has to shoot something, take it. He used to show it in the college. On the college, he had a project for that time. So he used to show us the films in the college projection room. So there were many people who inspired me that time, and especially my friends. People like Baiju, Jogi, Suhas, you know, they, Iqbal, you know, these people were there who used to always teasingly or whatever, they used to say, "Are this year, this week's hit is not there or what? Why don't we do a blockbuster for this week now? Come on, let us shoot something." So that also inspired you. And then I also overheard them saying, you know, Shirish is, they didn't say it in front of me, but behind my back, I heard them saying that Shirish is much better in cinema. So, you know, getting this feedback from your friends also makes a lot of difference for you. Yes, you believe. Yes, yes. I think I'm good at.
You're having that in you.
That is how, yeah. And this particular film did leave a big impression on me, Carlos Takarski. Okay. Huge impression. And I remember I saw it on 31st May. It was my birthday that day. That is the day when I saw. And very, this thing, when I met Murthy Saab in Bombay, Murthy, it was 31st May. Yeah. Coincidentally, it was 31st May, the day I met him physically. And we had a very long association later on. But I'll come to that later.
Yeah.
So, yes. That is how my transition of film happened, because I also, Jogi took me for a film called Junoon.
Mm-hmm.
And that is when this thing was rekindled. You know, I have to be a cinematographer. Rekindled. Because by the time it was okay, I'm shooting something. For the first time, I came to know that, you know, there is something more to it than what I think. Also, there was parallelly in 1982-83, there was a television serial called Bate Filmo Ki, which was running.
Mm-hmm.
And Benjamin Gilani used to hold a show.
Mm-hmm.
So there, in that show, they used to explain the technicalities. I think it was by FTI, probably.
Mm-hmm.
And they used to analyze the films. They used to analyze cinematography. They used to analyze storytelling. They used to analyze acting. So it was basically a film education sort of a show which was happening there on GD, that's right. Television had just become color in 90s shared during that time. So I saw these beautiful serials. Then there was Divya Natiya Wale karke ek serial. So these serials are very nicely shot. So, and I was slowly getting exposed to sort of cinema. And also I was working for Namhin Times that time under Vikram Vora.
Mm.
And one day Vikram Vora presented me a book on cinema. I read this book.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And that became my sort of a Bible for entering into films, because that had a huge information about Indian cinema, the tradition, right from Raja Harishchandra and prior to that, and Western cinema, influences of German cinema on Indian cinematographers. So yeah, that is what I kept on, that yes, matlab, these people were also influenced by somebody. So this is what basically influenced me also. So, you see, there are many contributions. I'm not, as I say, I am just a sort of a, you know, a patchwork of many influences. Like Francis paintings influenced me a lot. Baiju's paintings and by talks with Baiju, sitting and talking with Baiju,
okay,
influenced me a lot, because he was a very knowledgeable person. He is very knowledgeable person. So he used to talk about cinema, about Malayalam cinema. I saw quite some many films. Chimmin I saw with Baiju.
Uh-huh.
So a different approach to cinema. So then Jogi was very inspiring always. Arey, you can do it, you can do it. You know, that's all. So all these people who were there, they were always like with me.
Hmm.
They were always there. And that helped a lot physically in my transition to cinema. I did some things. Things worked somehow.
You also said that your school, in the college also, they encouraged you, the professors. You had
yes. College, people like Vishwambar sir encouraged me a lot, because he coaxed me to do a film on graphics.
Okay.
That is graphic printmaking, actually, film for Korea. Mm-hmm. It never happened because of various reasons.
Uh-huh.
But permission. But we did a full sort of a screenplay, we wrote a screenplay, we did drawings, how we are going to shoot it, you know, sort of, everything was laid, but eventually it never happened. I got so many films also, schools to shoot, but I use them elsewhere, you know. So it never happened. But yeah, but they did inspire me. Sir Vishwambar inspired me. Harihar sir used to like my works. musically, whatever I used to shoot musically. He was a teacher of portraiture. Because of him, right. I understood
even
light, basically, right. Portraiture. Yeah, so today, whatever portraiture I'm doing in cinema, I should always thank him for that. So there are, of course, masters like Rembrandt, Franz Hals, others were there to guide you in your unconscious mind. Vermeer, I like him a lot. All my writing is influenced by Vermeer. So all this knowledge of all these paintings, seeing all these works, you know, seeing Whistler, seeing Constable, you know, seeing all these people, seeing Sargent's drawings, basically, the line drawings of Sargent were amazing. Basically. Tone separation of Sargent, right. Just pencil, simple pencil and charcoal. It was amazing. So these things, of course, worked on me. Digamber Singhal worked on me a lot, you know. Digamber Singhal and I used to have huge discussions on acting and on drama, on theater, on staging. So that helped me a lot. And what you call completely free expression of Suhas. You know, he sagar rule padar mar apun ukar kire kar paye the.
Okay,
that is Suhas's approach. That also approaches there. Yeah, because he never believes in rules.
Jana.
Okay, he doesn't believe in rules, but then. Technically, we have to be in a rule.
Yeah.
But within that, how to explore yourself? Mm. How to melt those rules? Is something
within the confines of the confines of the rules. Yeah.
Yeah. And how do the rules melt by themselves? You don't have to melt them.
Exactly.
They get diffused into each other. It's like music. When you sing a lot, when you're an accomplished singer, you can easily blend one rag from another. You don't get stuck by the rules.
That is true.
You can easily blend. Yeah. I always give R.D. Burman as an example, ki how we used to blend everything, you know, and yet it was so harmonious, yet it was so beautiful. So, yeah, that is how it worked. Basically, all these friends, all the people, my mother who was serving and feeding all these people, she's the person who used to call them home. Mm-hmm. More than me, she was the person, arre takafai, akafai, jungalpa, ajjavan kela, ajjavan kela, call them.
Annapurna.
She was that way. So.
Yeah. That blessings are very important, in fact. I would say that you require some sort of a catalyst to move ahead at every point of time. So also these people were sort of catalyst to you in some form or the other. Probably not in a big way, but small ways which grew up and you are what you are.
I suppose everybody is.
Yeah.
I suppose everybody is, but people don't realize it.
That's true.
Most of them don't realize it.
Yeah,
it is good to be aware.
Yeah, that's good.
It is not by realizing that you are going to do something different.
Right.
But it is nice to be aware. It is nice to be humble.
Right.
And to know that you are not a maker of your own.